Many, many centuries ago, I was a senior in high school. The allies and adversaries, trials and tribulations, successes and setbacks, those 4 years were some of the most influential in my development. I can remember it as if it were yesterday. Or 3 months ago. Anyway, in our high school, our yearbook had senior quotes. If you were a graduating senior, you could include some kind of quote to be added along with your photo. It's often regarded as something that you might revisit in 30 years and chuckle at. Nothing too important. That's not how I regarded it, though. Sure, a senior quote can be something insignificant and meaningless, but I think it can represent something more. It's something that can serve as an encapsulation of your legacy at the school, what you were involved in, or something that you achieved. It could highlight your personality, or perhaps it's something that you really believe in. I wish I knew this when I was trying to figure out what I wanted my senior quote to be. I didn't know where to begin at all, and it was something that kept lingering in my head for many, many weeks. So, for those of you high school seniors in a similar position, I offer you 5 pieces of advice. Number 1. Be genuine. Even if all of the people around you are saying really, really profound things, quotes by Obama and Maya Angelou, feel free to just be yourself. If you want to share a line from SpongeBob, you go share that line from SpongeBob. Number 2. Begin taking mental notes of cool stuff that you hear. This gives you some ideas for things to put down as your quote in the future. Even just writing down names of people you really admire is a good start, and it'll leave you in a better position by the time you have to submit your quote. Number 3. Keep character counts in mind. If you're given information about how many characters your quote has to be limited to, vetting quotes that exceed this limit beforehand is much better than realizing the day before the deadline. From personal experience, I wanted to use a quote by Conan O'Brien from a speech the night he left NBC. But it was too long, so I instead went with a quote from my boy, popular commentary YouTuber Drew Gooden, when he was explaining his approach to creating vines back in 2016. All this is to say that you should try to fit your quote within limits before it's too late. Number 4. Try not to put something really overused. Okay, let me just put it this way. If I had a dollar for every time I saw a meme from The Office as someone's senior quote, I'd have 1,000,000 Stanley Nichols. I'm just gonna say it.
There's better comedy shows out there.
How dare you defile the name of Michael Scott, our savior!
Though I personally think The Office is just a smidge overrated, if you really want to put one down, go for it. I'm not gonna stop you. But just try to put some thought into it. You do want to make your quote memorable after all. On that note, my last word of advice is to see if you can make your quote more interesting. I've seen some pretty creative things out there, and feel free to use these as an inspiration. First, mismatching quotes and people are really funny. If you took someone who made a really big impact and says a lot of profound things, like Abraham Lincoln, for example, and then you add that with something that just your average Joe would say, you get something that's kind of hilarious. Second, people with the same last name, or who are directly adjacent to each other, can coordinate quotes together. So if you've got siblings or a bro whose name is right next to yours in the alphabet, you can make something really creative out of that. And finally, this is just a really cool quote that I saw. My friend from high school had an amazing idea, which was, "Kids, if you're reading this, I love you," which is such a powerful, beautiful quote. It gives me very, very Iron Man 2 vibes when Tony Stark's like, you know, "Oh, I'm dying of the element." And then he looks at the projector and he sees his dad and he's like, "My greatest creation is you." And then he's like, "Oh my God." And that concludes my advice for seniors. Editing this, I realized that this video was kind of a hot mess. But at the same time, it's something that I really wish I had heard during the September of my senior year. Seriously though, if this does eventually help one person make or find an epic senior quote, I think it was worth it. Thank you for watching this video. If you want to see more content like this in the future, please consider subscribing. And I'm really glad that you decided to spend some time with me learning about the wonderful world of senior quotes. Thanks.